Alright, Astrid, I'm going to record this little video for you. So essentially when I do this videos, I'm, you know, obviously going to play stuff that you're going to have to practice with. But I also want to review things that we talked about. Bowing, like I said, you can kind of do anything you really want on two strings. But really, any patterns of 1 to 4. So you could go... each string, 2, you can do it on any strings, and you can practice at different speeds, but do definitely try to be consistent with your speed. I mean, if you're going to play at one speed, keep it that speed. Do 3s and 4s. And you could do 4. Right. And you can do this with a metronome too to help you practice. I can show you different ways of doing that. The last bow exercise we went over is doing long bows. And not so long that we use the whole bow, which takes a little more skill. It takes a lot of control and flexibility, and also controlling the weight of how much you let your arm rest into the bow. So the exercise we're going to do is going to be that down, up, down, and we'll start, you know, just a little bit above the hand, not so close, but just a little bit above, and we can pick our D string, down, up, down, and then once we get closer to the tip, up, down, up. Down, up, down. And if you hit another string, practice and focus. It could be that you're holding the violin weird. I'm holding it weird so you can see what I'm doing. I don't usually play the violin leaned over like this, but that's why I'm holding it this way. Maybe I'll bring the camera closer so I don't have to lean so weirdly. So, down, up, down. Up, down, up. Down, up, down. In terms of the pressure, I don't use too much pressure when I'm changing directions, and I don't really use much weight. It's more of like a pull and a push, rather than me pushing down. You know, I'm pulling sideways and pushing sideways, up and down, pull and a push.